Sue is the oldest in terms of when it died T-Rex that we know of, and it shows its age. There are all sorts of things wrong with the skeleton, which is interesting to us. It tells us something about the life of a T-Rex. We are going to take a couple bones off of Sue's skeleton, real bones that are diseased, and we're trying to find out what the disease was.
One of the ones we're going to look at is the left fibula, the outer bone of the lower leg. Here is the right fibula of Sue as a cast, and you can see it has a nice tapering slender shaft. By contrast, the left one, it has these massive bone overgrowths, and there might be a sort of a canal even draining from there. And so we're hoping to use CT scanning to understand what the injury or the cause of these bone overgrowths are. We are collaborating with a team of medical researchers from Berlin and from UIC who are going to help us use CT technology to look inside some of the bones of Sue.
We wanted to investigate what the exact cause is. Also to get to know how Sue's life was back then, 60 million years ago, and to study the evolution of disease.
When you think of the bone of the T-Rex, you can think of it as a stone. It's very dense and it's packed with elements of iron, calcium, and magnesium, much denser than the bones of the human body. What we did in Berlin up to date was we performed also CT scans of the T-Rex in Berlin, which was unearthed a few years back. And the challenging task about this was to set up the parameters of a clinical CT scanner to actually enable the X-rays to penetrate the bone. For the X-rays to penetrate the bone, it needs a much higher current. Such a current would be harmful for the human body. With this 3D reconstruction, we will be able also to share the insights and the 3D reconstruction with the society and the researchers of society all over the world. And researchers from all different continents of the planet will be able to work on Sue's bones.